I really need to sell stuff because I'm full of trash, apparently. And I think not every trader might... I'm at least not sure, but it might be like some only buy some stuff from you when you're trying to sell. Oh, wait, wait, wait. Oh, damn it. Turret control. Can I reconfigure the parameters? There we go. At least I have avenged my wife. At least I'm in good with them. That's some fancy stuff they have when everything is rusty and destroyed. I guess they have been able to create their own metals and put together those. What's this? Peeking his tongue out. Oh yeah, the map. Why can't I fast travel from here? I wonder where they are headed. They probably got the message from those I helped. Perhaps something big is going on because, you know, that was like a carrier or something. They brought an army with them.
If you're thinking safety, a long-range rifle lets you stay in cover and out of sight. But you might want a secondary weapon for flexibility.
Yeah, let's see what you got.
Good advice.
Self-defense at its best.
Let's sell everything that's Institute. Composite, yeah, let's sell that. What do I need a crystal for? This is quite valuable. This too. Formal hat. It's probably the guy that I killed from before. The mafia dude. Oh, this one is pretty heavy. Let's just sell it. I don't think I'll have much use for it. Glowing fungus. Ah, save it. I can heal. Oh yeah, this one. I'm supposed to put that back home or something. Not sure if it's good to sell nuclear materials to a guy like this, but probably works.
Hey, you see that big blimp? What's the Brotherhood of Steel?
You? I don't know you. Just keep your distance.
All right.
Keep calm. I'm standing still.
That's exactly what a synth would say. But I don't know. Are you still the human?
Human as the day I was born.
Well, you do look human enough. But I'll be watching you. I have eyes like a... Well, they're good eyes. Got it? All right. We can do business, but no funny stuff.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Just don't call it junk.
She's quite funny. Yeah, I don't think I'll be needing this tuxedo. It's bad memories. No. But what weighs so much? It's probably that goddamn minigun. I should put it back to the rocket place.
No skull in the league. Where it is? Something bad went down in the old museum of witchcraft up in the cell.
Nikki Valentine walks into my office for a change.
What can I say, Piper? You, me, and hard luck all seem to run together like acid rain down an old sewer.
You, including your client here in that analogy? So, you two are finally letting me in on this little case of yours. What's the story?
You were eating on it!
I didn't make it in time. Kellogg was working with the Institute, and he gave them Sean. I've lost him all over again.
The Institute. Oh, boy. I've been investigating these creeps for over a year now. The Commonwealth's boogeyman. Feared and hated by everyone.
True enough.
Sometimes they snatch people in the middle of the night. And sometimes they leave old synths behind to remind us that they're out there. But to this day, there's one thing nobody really knows.
Where the Institute actually is. Or how to get in.
Exactly. But there's one person who has to know, right? The guy who just handed them Sean.
Kellogg. Huh.
Well...
He's whatever dead. You're thinking. It doesn't matter. He's dead.
Yeah, I knew he wasn't gonna go quietly the moment I saw him.
So, a murderer and a kidnapper gets his brains blown out by an avenging parent. Huh. Be a great ending if we didn't still have the biggest mystery in the Commonwealth to solve.
Doesn't matter what he knew. I'd kill him again in a heartbeat.
Gets his brains blown out. Huh. His brains. You know, we may not need the man at all.
You're talking crazy here, Nick. Got a fault in the old subroutines?
Look, there's a place in Good Neighbor called the Memory Den. Relive the past moments in your mind as clear as the day they happened. If anyone could get a dead brain to sing, it'll be Dr. Amari, the mind behind the memories.
Shot his brain to bits. This won't work.
There's no way that could ever work.
Stay with me on this. We get a piece of Kellogg's gray matter and take it to Amari. Then we see if she's got the goods to pull this off.
Jesus, Nick, grow seriously?
I know it's grisly, but what choice do we have? We got no leads, nothing. That old merc's brain just might have all the secrets we need to know.
What exactly do we need, Nick?
Kellogg's brain. It's a long shot, but Dr. Amari just might be able to get it jump-started. See what the old merc knew.
Do I seriously have to run all the way back over there to collect his brain?
Actually, I think I already have something. Kellogg had this thing attached to his head.
Cybernetics, huh? We may have just won the lottery.
Whether we're riding this crazy brain train or not, we can't all go running across the Commonwealth, so who's coming with you?
I have to go to the memory den either way, if I'm going to introduce you to Amari. But if you want to head there together, just say so.
I sold most of his parts to the Mexican outside, so...
Anything else you can tell me about the memory den?
It's in Good Neighbor, a little slice of trouble northeast a ways. The memory den ain't just a fancy name, it's literal. A lot of people give up all their caps just to relive the good parts of their lives. Over and over. But not us. We're gonna try to dive deep into someone else's mind. I can meet you there or we can head out together.
I'll head out with Piper. We'll meet you there, Nick.
Sounds good. You two stay out of trouble. Don't worry. We're gonna get your boy back. Just a few more steps.
That sounded really reassuring. I would like to have that in real life sometime. But I would know it's lies, so it's pointless. Oh, I thought it was someone standing dancing in front of me. Ah, at least I don't have to go and scrap someone's brain. But first, I'm gonna drop off the damn minigun. Level up! Power! Power! Yes! Where quiet means not. Ah, must be level 12. What other. Whoa! This thing is insane! Oh, that's without a companion. I'm a guy who walks with friends, so no. Well, not in real life. Blah blah blah! Let's get more of maximum health, because health have been a problem of mine.
If you wanted to make me a second printing press while you're at it. Ah, what were you hiding?
Damn it, I need more stuff.
Take a look at this.
Where should I store my weapon? Let's store the minigun in a file cabinet. That makes a lot of sense, right? Minigun. How much it weigh? Oh, 27. It's a lot, but I pressed the wrong key. Damn it. It's a lot, but it doesn't explain the rest of the weight. It's so much. Perhaps it's everything combined. I don't know. I haven't counted. Let's go to the good neighbor then. I don't remember what our idea was. All right, Piper. This way. Fire! Oh no, zombies! This is not The Walking Dead! Piper! Come on, get up, Piper. I don't want to use a steam pack on you. Come on. She needs to learn how to handle herself better in combat. Doesn't seem to go too well for her. Seems as if I can't have those pieces on my trench coat. Damn it. Sneaking past those big ugly trolls. What's with those legendary rats? Where did it go? No! The legendary one, it just disappeared! I wanted to loot it! Come on, Piper, let's go. Oh no, don't tell me she ran away. Wait, do I have to walk up on this one? Darn it.
Hiding for me?
What? Piper, where are you? I think I have to go follow this road to find the objective. That's raiders. Oh, whoops. My ammo. Darn it. Let's change primary weapon. Because obviously I'm getting low on ammo. Alright, let's use the Tommy gun. Come on, Piper. No noise.
It was nothing.
Exactly. I'm nobody. So if you saw somebody, then you tell them nobody was here. Victory! Ah! Hi, Mr. Finn. Alright, busy smoking.
Hey there.
What's the word?
A new player in Good Neighbor. Hello, little pawn. Welcome to our fun and games.
Not sure if I want to speak to you. Let's just skip these people. Freak Show Town. Pretty much everything is in this world. But it's fun that they try to keep older elementals. Elements.
Well, Mr. Valentine, I thought you had forgotten about little old me.
May have walked out of the den, Irma, but I'd never walk out on you.
Amari's downstairs, you big flirt.
Not sure if a human would interact with a machine on this
here
kind of manner.
Here for Amari, she's downstairs.
Sorry about that.
Dr. Amari?
Yes. I take it this isn't a social call.
This one's all yours, Nick.
We need a memory dig, Amari, but it's not going to be easy. The perp, Kellogg, is already cold on the floor.
Are you too mad? Putting aside the fact that you're asking me to defile a corpse, you don't realize that the memory simulators require intact, living brains to function.
Isn't there some way to make this work?
This dead brain had inside knowledge of the Institute, Amari. The biggest scientific secret of the Commonwealth. You need this, and so do we.
Fine. I'll take a look. But no guarantees. Do you have it with you?
Here's what I could find.
What's this? This isn't a brain. This is... Wait, that's the hippocampus. And this thing attached to it? A neural interface?
Those circuits look awfully familiar.
I'm not surprised. From what I've seen, all Institute technology has a similar architecture.
So the brain is still good, right?
Possibly. There's no sign of decay, so the tech is probably preserving the tissue. Injecting some kind of compound to keep it stable. But there's no way to access the memories inside without a compatible port.
You're talking about me, right? I'm an old synth. If the Institute built me out of similar parts, we might have an in.
There could be long-term side effects. I don't know where to even begin with listing the risks.
Don't bother. I don't need to hear them. Plug me in, Doc.
I appreciate this, Nick.
You can thank me when we've found your son. All right, let's do this.
Whenever you're ready, Mr. Valentine, just sit down.
If I start cackling like an old grizzled mercenary, pull me out, okay?
Let's see here. I need you to keep talking to me, Mr. Valentine. Any slight change in your cognitive functions could be dire. Are you feeling any different?
There's a lot of flashes. Static. I can't make sense of any of it, Doc.
That's what I was afraid of. The mnemonic impressions are encoded. It appears the Institute has one last failsafe. There's a lock on the memories in the implant.
tell me you have a way past this, Doc.
Let me think. The encryption is too strong for a single mind. But what if we use two? We load both you and Mr. Valentine into the memory loungers. Run your cognitive functions in parallel. He'll act as a host, while your consciousness drives through whatever memories we can find.
All right. Let's get started.
Just sit down over there, and keep your fingers crossed.
See you on the other side.
Yeah. See ya. Oh, wrong shirt. It's a nice thing of him trying to sacrifice himself, risk everything that he is, to help me find my son.
Brainwave migration between the transplant and the host. Mnemonic activity coming from the transplant. It's degenerated, but it's there. We're going to load you into the strongest memories we can find. They might not be stable. Just hold on. Can you hear me? Ah, good. The simulation appears to be working, although the memories are quite fragmentary. I'll try to step you through the intact memories and hope we find one that gives us some clue to the Institute's location. There. This is the earliest intact memory I can find. Are experiencing these memories as Kellogg. This may prove disorienting at first.
I was such a dummy back then. What did I know about how the world worked? I think Mom knew how it was. She wasn't soft, but she loved me.
This doesn't seem to be what we're looking for.
And she protected me from Dad.
There appears to be another intact
memory. That cost her more than a few beatings.
Temporal sequence.
I never...
There. Try that one.
The thing about happiness is... you only know you had it when it's gone. I mean, you may think to yourself that you're happy, but... you don't really believe it. Focus on that... petty bullshit or next job or whatever. It's only looking back, by comparison with what comes after, that you really understand that's what happiness felt like. I was the worst thing that ever happened to her. If she'd never met me,
let's keep looking.
She'd have stayed
I'll
in the
connect
hub
you to the next
maybe hooked
memory.
Up with someone who didn't kill people for a living. Probably been happier than she was with me. Almost certainly lived longer.
How did you think this was gonna end, Kellogg? You thought you could just fuck with us, and we wouldn't fuck with you? Just so you know, they died like dogs. And you weren't there to help them.
I found another memory to try. I'll connect you.
Mind if we sit down?
Suit yourself. I don't remember much from that time. It all kind of blends together.
Well, we seem to be getting
closer.
It was
closer. Almost always a bar,
though. Try this
though.
Next one.
That's universal.
Seems like we have gone very far back into his
Mr.
memory.
Mr. Kellogg, I'm glad you decided to meet with me.
So, you're with the Institute. I wanted to see for myself if you really existed.
We do, as you can see.
What do you want?
It's come to my attention that you've been rather disruptive of our operations lately. This must stop.
I do what people pay me to do. If that's a problem for you, I could see only one way out.
And what's that, Mr. Kellogg?
If I'm working for you, there's no more problem. From what I hear, you can afford me.
I don't think you fully understand the situation you're in.
I think I do.
Very well. B-748, initiate.
Systems offline.
Impressive. We may have something to talk about after all.
Getting warmer. One of these has got to tell us something. We're running out of brain here. There's one that looks mostly intact. Connecting now.
Manual override initiated. Cryogenic stasis suspended.
Vault computers are still working. That's good. Checking through the logs. Hopefully it's all...
Just... find it.
Pod C6. Down the hall near the end.
This is the one. Here.
Open it. Almost. Everything's going to be fine.
Come here. Come here, babe.
No, no. I've got him.
Let the boy go. I'm only going to tell you once.
I'm not giving you Sean!
God damn it. Get the kid out of here and let's go. At least we still have backup.
Cryogenic sequence reinitialized.
What's the holdup?
I'm almost finished, Kellogg. I just need to confirm. Come on, come on. All right, we're good.
I'm sorry you had to go through that again. I found another intact memory. Whenever you're ready.
Damn asshole. Oh, probably on the other side. At least I killed the son of a bitch in a brutal manner and then dishonored his corpse, or desecrated. Vandalized it. Mutilated it.
Is that your son? This appears to be a very recent memory. So, good news, I think.
Wasn't my idea to settle down with the kid in the middle of Diamond City. I thought it was a terrible idea, actually. But it was one of the old man's pet projects, so here we were. Me and the kid. Like a happy little family. I ended up kind of liking it. A reminder of what my life might have been if things had turned out differently. But there's no going back. I knew it was just temporary. It'd be back to normal business before too long. This whole setup in Diamond City was part of some elaborate plan of the old man's. Seems obvious now that we were bait for our friend from the vault. Timing couldn't have been an accident. It's not how the old man works. I wonder if he outsmarted me in the end. Another loose end tied up.
Huh?
Kellogg.
It's okay. One of these days you're gonna get your head blown off just barging in here like that.
Minimizing my exposure to civilians is a priority.
Forget I said anything. So what's the big crisis this time?
New orders for you. One of our scientists has left the Institute.
left? As in...
He's gone rogue. Name's Dr. Brian Virgil. We know he's hiding somewhere in the glowing sea. Here's his file.
Wow. Some heads are gonna roll for this. Capture and return, or just elimination?
Elimination. He was working on a highly classified program.
No kidding. One of the top bioscience boys? Damn. So, I guess you're taking the kid back with you.
Affirmative. Your only mission is to locate and eliminate Virgil.
You're taking me home to my father?
Yes. Stand next to me and hold still.
Okay.
X688, ready to relay with Sean.
Bye, Mr. Kellogg. I hope I see you again soon.
Bye.
Teleportation. Now it all makes sense. Nobody's found the entrance to the Institute because there is no entrance. Let me pull you out of there as soon as you're ready.
No, get me out!
I don't know what kind of side effects the procedure might have had. No one's ever done this before. How do you feel?
I'm okay, Doctor. Thank you.
That's good. But I want you to keep monitoring yourself. We have to be sure there's no long-term damage. Are you ready to talk about what happened in there?
You were along for the ride, weren't you? You saw what I saw.
Yes, but it's important we review everything together, in case either of us missed anything.
There's more than one person who knows about the Institute. Virgil, that scientist who escaped.
I didn't know Institute scientists could defect. This changes everything. He could answer all sorts of questions. Where did the memory say he was? The glowing sea? That can't be right. No one would risk going there. Not even to hide.
That's why he's there. To make the Institute think twice about following him.
That must be it. He's using the radiation and the glowing sea like a shield or a cloak. A way to throw them off and be at an advantage. If Virgil found a way to survive there, you'll have to do the same. If you're going to follow him.
How do I fight that much radiation, Doctor?
There are chemical compounds. Radex, Radaway. You'd need as much as you could carry. Maybe more. A sealed environment suit would be great, if you could find one. Or maybe one of those suits of power armor? That would be perfect.
I got one, but I haven't been able to find enough steel to repair it.
I'll find a way to get through the rads. Don't worry.
Good luck, and be safe. By the way, I unplugged Mr. Valentine first. Removed the implant while you were waking up. He's waiting for you upstairs.
Heads up.
Point the way.
Over here.
Of course.
Wait there.
Okay.
Come on.
I'll be here then. Yep.
Ah, those commands. Valentine was upstairs. Perhaps she meant up here. Upstairs. No, she did not. Never mind this. Damn it. Just follow them damn mark. Oh, there he is.
Hey, Valentine.
Hope you got what you were looking for inside my head. I was right. I should have killed you when you were on ice.
Kellogg? Is that you?
What? What are you talking about?
You feeling all right, Nick?
Yeah, I'm fine. Why?
You sounded like Kellogg just then.
Did I? Huh. Amari said there might be some mnemonic impressions left over. Anyway, I feel fine, so let's get going. Or I could head back to Diamond City, since you've got company already.
We have to head into the Glowing Sea. Any advice?
I'm a synth, so radiation isn't much of an issue for me, but an old suit of power armor might just be the guardian angel you're looking for. That, or you could buy up all the Rad-X and Rad-Away you can find from any chem dealer who's got it in stock.
There's something wrong with you, Nick. I don't want you with me.
I told you I'm fine. But I get it. Going through Kellogg's brain was a doozy for both of us. I'll be in Diamond City when you've had time to cool off.
Escaping real life into this virtual world. Total Recall all over again.